In this video, you'll learn how to create view types for floor plan views, section views, and elevation views. View types are available by default in Revit and don't necessarily have to be customized, but additional customization can be added to help with some view workflows. Let's take a look at some examples. Right now, a floor plan view is the active view, and if you look in the type selector, you can see that the type is simply floor plan. When you click Edit Type, you can open the Type Properties dialog for the floor plan view type. To create a new view type for floor plan views, click Duplicate, and then you can enter a name. I will name this one Floor Plan-Architecture. And then I'll click OK to close the dialog, and now we have a new floor plan type. For the type properties, there's really just a few. You can specify the callout tag, the reference label, and then you can choose a view template that's applied to new views. For example, I'll click the button that currently says none, and it'll open the Assign View Template dialog. I'll select Architectural Plan and then click OK. And now you can see Architectural Plan is the view template that will be applied to new views. The next checkbox right below this will control whether new views are dependent on the template. And what that means is that when this checkbox is selected or enabled, then the view template will not only be applied, but it will be assigned to any new view created of this type. If you deselect the checkbox, it'll simply be applied, and then you can make any additional adjustments to the view properties without affecting the view template. So for this example, I'm going to select new views are dependent on template, and then I'll simply click apply. Now we have a floor plan-architecture view type. And next, I'll click Duplicate again, and we'll create another view type. This one I will name Floor Plan-Working. Then I'll click OK. And for the working type, I'm going to deselect New Views Are Dependent on Template. So what will happen when we use this type is that the floor plan will initially have those view properties as defined in the architectural plan view template, but then we can make additional adjustments to the view properties as needed. I'll click OK to close the type properties dialog, and then I'll switch to the view tab, and in the create panel, I'll expand the plan views button and click floor plan. Now, when we create a new floor plan, we can choose the type. We can use one of the existing types, or we can use one of the new types we just created. For example, I'll select Floor Plan-Working, and then I'll select the second floor level, and then I'll click OK. When I do, a new floor plan is created, and if we look in the properties palette, next to the view template parameter, we can see that it's set to none because it does not have a view template assigned. But if we go through that process one more time to create a new floor plan, and this time we'll select the floor plan-architecture, and then I'll select the second floor level again and click OK. And now we can see that it has the architectural plan view template assigned. So that's the difference there between the view template type parameters when creating a new floor plan view type. Next, on the view tab in the create panel, I'll click section to activate the section tool, and then we can expand the type selector to see the section view types. And for section views, there's two system families, detail view and section. and you can create as many view types as needed for each of those system families. For example, I'll collapse the type selector and then click Edit Type to open the Type Properties dialog. And for section views, you can specify the callout tag, the section tag, and the reference label. And then there are also those same view template parameters. So you can choose a view template for section views as well as elevation view types. For the callout tag and section tag, you can click in the field. For example, I'll click in the section tag field and then click the More button. And this opens the Type Properties dialog for section tags. So be aware that you're actually adjusting a type. You're not simply just changing to another option. You actually have to have a type created for the section tag. And in this exercise file, there are three types created, and they have varying section heads, tails, and then the broken section display style. For example, I'll change it to the second option here, and then we can see once again the section head and section tail options. If you wanted to create a new type for the section tag, you could simply click duplicate and then adjust the section head, the section tail, and the broken section display style. And then whatever's selected here in the type dropdown, when you click OK, will be specified for the section tag. Then I'll click OK. And I'm gonna click modify to end the command, and then I'm gonna go back to the ground floor overall plan. And if we take a look here at an existing section type, we can select one and see the type. And if I change it to wall section, you can see how that section head updates to what we changed it before. I'll change it back to building section. So one thing that you can do here is you can create working section types as well as documentation section types and have different heads so that the users can distinguish between them in the project. Very similarly, with elevation view types, you can control the elevation tag, the callout tag, and the reference label, as well as the view template parameters. I'll click cancel. And when you are creating a section or an elevation, you can choose to reference another view by selecting Reference Other View on the Contextual Ribbon tab, and then you can choose the view that you want to reference. If you're creating an elevation, it can be another elevation or a new drafting view. If you're creating a section, it can be another section that you're referencing or a new drafting view. I'll click Modify to end the command. And once again, be aware that you can customize the floor plan view types as well as section and elevation view types to help distinguish between the different types of views in your project.